Hi, I'm Dr. Young. What happens when a firm charges a different price for different consumers? This is a market strategy called price discrimination. When a monopolist cannot practice price discrimination, the optimal point of production for a monopolist is where the marginal cost of production equals the marginal revenue. The output is lower than that produced under perfect competition. This creates a deadweight loss, the size of the red shaded triangle. However, companies can sell the same goods at different prices to different consumers. Movie theaters often offer student or senior citizen discounts, for example. This practice is called price discrimination. There are three types of price discrimination: first, second, and third degree, along with the hurdle model. Monopolists are more profitable when they can practice price discrimination, but price discrimination can also be more efficient at the social level. A first degree price discrimination describes the most extreme form of market segmentation. If a monopolist knows how much each consumer would pay, it can charge its customers exactly what they would be willing to pay for the product. Here, consumer surplus is zero because there is no difference between what a buyer is willing to pay and what a buyer does pay. Rather than go to waste, it becomes part of the producer surplus, the blue shaded area. The monopolist gets it all. Second degree price discrimination sets a price schedule that declines as the quantity of the product purchased goes up. Take electricity pricing schedules, where, say, the first 200 kilowatt hours of electricity are charged at 10 cents per kilowatt hour, the next 300 kilowatt hours are charged at 9 cents per kilowatt hour, and so on. As in the previous case, the producer surplus is much larger compared to a setting where monopolist charges a single price. However, this time, consumers keep some of their surplus, the orange shaded area. As the monopolist has imperfect knowledge of each consumer's willingness to pay, they cannot extract all available surplus. Third degree price discrimination charges different prices based on customer characteristics, such as demographic information or occupation. A local bookstore might offer 10% off to teachers and college students, for example. Museums offer discounts to senior citizens or students. The monopolist practices the traditional monopoly pricing strategy, charging a price such that marginal cost is equal to marginal revenue on the inferred demand for each single subgroup. In the hurdle model of price discrimination, the seller puts up a hurdle and offers discounted prices to those consumers that are willing to jump the hurdle. For instance, some stores offer discounted prices to consumers who pay a membership fee. Let's circle back to the issue of efficiency at the social level. The first graph shows the optimal pricing of a monopolist when it can only charge one price. While the monopolist makes more profits, there is also a social loss compared to perfect competition. That is because the monopolist must restrict supply to sustain higher prices. That social loss, called deadweight loss, corresponds to the red shaded area. The second and third graphs represent the surplus division in the first and second degree price discrimination, respectively. Here, the deadweight loss has disappeared. By charging different prices, the monopolist can now expand production to a perfectly competitive level and make more profits at the same time. Under first degree price discrimination, consumer surplus is virtually gone. But that is a catch with the concept of efficiency. In economics, something is defined as efficient if it maximizes social surplus, the sum of producer and consumer surplus, even if distribution is arguably uneven. Feel free to visit Chegg to see pre-solved examples or ask one of our subject matter experts. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.